Hello and welcome to our first Wix Editor lesson. In this lesson, I'm going to show you how to begin working with the Wix Editor. So let's begin. First, let's take a look at some of the templates that Wix has to offer. Wix actually has hundreds of templates that you can choose from. For example, business and services templates, stores, creative templates, community, and also blog templates. You can also choose blank templates if you'd like to start from scratch. In this case, we're going to choose a template to work with, so let's scroll down and have a look. You can see here we have some really nice templates. I think we'll choose this template here on the right. I really like it, I think it looks so professional. So let's click Edit. Great, here we have our template, so we're ready to get started. Let's take a look at some of the most useful buttons and tools that we can use while editing our site. First, we have the desktop icon. This tells us that we're editing our site for desktop. Beside this, we can switch to mobile, which will allow us to edit our site on mobile. But don't worry, we're going to cover this in another lesson. Over here, we have Save, which will allow us to save our work as we go so we don't lose anything important. Preview, so we can take a look at our site and make sure it's perfect before we publish. And Publish. So now let's move over to the left panel. At the top here, we have the Add panel. Here we can add different elements to our site. You can see we can add a strip, text, images, button, gallery, decorative elements, interactive elements, and as you can see, the list goes on. Next, we have the Pages panel. Here is where you can see all of your site pages. Next, we have the Site Design. Here you can see that we've chosen a site theme. In just one click, you can change the whole look and feel of your site here. You can also customize your theme. Next, we have the Wix App Market. Here you can see we have hundreds of apps that you can choose from that you can link to your site. Next, we have My Business, and this is where you can manage the apps that you've already added. The Media Manager is next. Here you can upload your own media. You can also see the site files you've previously uploaded. We can see the Photo Studio, the Video Maker, free Wix images that you can use, and also free Wix videos. The last button is the Ascend tool. This can help you to drive traffic to your site and also help you to promote your site. Next, we'll come over to the right. Here we have the Undo button and the Redo button. Next, we have Zoom Out and Reorder. Zoom Out and Reorder is great. You can zoom out and then you can rearrange whatever order your content is in. Next, we have Tools. Here we have a toolbar, the Layers panel, rulers, grid lines, and Snap to Objects. I find the Tools panel really helpful when I'm trying to edit my site. Over here, we have Search. Here you can search for anything that you might need in the editor. So for example, you might want to add a box. Let's go ahead and type in box. You can see here, when we hover over themed boxes, the themed boxes open up on the left. Also the same for box slideshows and multi-state boxes. The search panel is very handy. Now we've covered all the tools, let's get to the fun part. We're going to take a look at the editor stage. This section that you currently see here is called the Above the Fold section, and this is the first section that your site visitors are going to see. So really, it's the most important section. This is where we want to grab our site visitors' attention. So how do we do this? We need to tell them who we are, what we do, and where we would like them to click. So for example, if you were a store, you would give your store name, you would explain what your store is selling, and then you would maybe add a Buy Now button to direct your user to. With this in mind, let's take a look at the actual page structure. Here at Wix, we have a header, a page, and a footer. The header and footer are master elements. Let's click the header and take a look. We can go to the Tools panel, go to Layers, and click Header. We can see now the header is open. You can see that the elements inside the header are all orange. This is because they're going to be on all pages. Every orange element will be applied to all pages, and this is important to remember. You can see here we have some of our best elements up here. So we have the company name, a logo, we also have our menu and a call to action. It's important to place the menu in the header so that it appears on all pages so that your site visitor is able to navigate your site. Let's move down the page. Next we have the page. This page is mostly made up of strips. You can see here we have a text box. I'll show you how to edit some text. Let's double click and we can delete some text. It's simple like that. We'll double click again so we can re-add the text. Perfect. We'll keep scrolling down and take a look at the rest of the site. You can see here the strips that have been added and the elements that have been added. Below here, we can click into the footer. The footer elements are equally as important as the header. You can see here that, for example, that we've placed Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, TikTok, and YouTube. We also have terms and conditions, shipping and returns, and the privacy policy. Let's scroll back up and take a look at the header scroll. We can click here into the header and go to settings. Currently, the header scroll is set to freezes. So let's go to preview and see what that looks like. You can see here in preview as we scroll down that the header remains as we scroll. So let's go back and choose a different type of header scroll. We'll click the header, go to settings, and this time let's choose disappears. We'll go to preview and see how it looks. You can see this time as we scroll, the header completely disappears. Let's go back. For this site, I think we're going to keep the header frozen, so let's do that. Perfect. So now we've taken a look at some of the tools and buttons, and I've also told you about the page structure, including the header, the page, and the footer. Now I want to show you something else that's really cool. We're going to go to the Add panel and go down to Social. Here we will choose one of the social bars. So let's choose this grey one and drag it onto the stage. We can see that it's attaching to the strip. Now what we'll do is we're going to pin it to the screen. So let's right click and we'll go pin to screen. You can choose exactly where this element is pinned to, for example the bottom, the left, in this case we'll choose the right centre. Great, but you can see that it doesn't look perfect, so let's see what else we can do. If we go to layouts, we can actually change it from horizontal to vertical, so let's do that. Amazing, now we can see that this will scroll as we scroll. This is good for an element that you'd like to show on the site the whole time while your visitor is there. Now I'll show you a new trick. What we will do is right click and go down to show on all pages. Watch what happens when we click this. You can see that the box around this element changed from blue to orange, and this means this will now show on all pages, like the other master elements. Let's take a look at preview and see how this looks. Perfect. As you can see here, the social bar remains as we scroll. So, in this lesson, I took you through all the buttons and tools that you'll need to create an amazing site. I also spoke to you about the page structure, how important the above the fold section is, the header, the page, and the footer. We also pinned an element to the screen and set it to show on all pages. I really hope you've enjoyed this lesson, and I look forward to seeing you in lesson 2. In lesson 2, we're going to cover layouts. I'll see you there.